Welcome back to the party. We are here with episode 4 of season 2 of ReZero. Let's get started. As always, there's a link in the description that will send you to Crunchyroll, which is where I am watching ReZero. Bring the episode down to zero, and we're going to play at the same time. So when you're ready, in 3, 2, 1, go. So he's back in his real world, or maybe it's just an hallucination, but my God. I didn't realize, if one, his dad is fucking ripped, two, Subaru was able to stop him there for a second. You woke him up by strangling him. Is this like the challenge? Does he have to like get over this whole thing? That's a lot of peas. He looks a lot like his dad. He's even pushed it over to her. Just split it up. That's very specifically picky. So he's not aware of the other world, I guess. He's just like, your world is back, and you're back, and nothing happened. I feel like this is the first time that a protagonist has gone back to his real world in the isekai. Probably not the first time, but it's the first time I've seen it. See, now that doesn't look bad. That's a lot of food to start out the day. You're dying, Subaru. That's a weird... Why is it so oval? Why is a clock oval? What happens when it's past 8? Looks like it really wants you to go. It's moonwalking in, all right. I mean, there is. She has silver hair and pointy ears. She uses magic. What about school? Does that not matter? And why can Japanese kids just not go to school? You can't do that in America. Sorry, I was picking up cobwebs on my webcam. It's also weird that a main protagonist has a father in his life, because that also doesn't happen often. They look just like each other, so. Is no one gonna notice that he's just like in pain? It's a decent question. Packed with my love. You didn't make it, you just fucking bought the thing. I don't think soda's gonna make you feel any better. That's not generally how that works. Yeah, but you can be in your nice comfy bed. Maybe it's telling you to go to school. There's no subject left. The conversation ended. You've asked that already. Amelia. Whatever put him there, it really wants him to go to school. Because every time he says he doesn't want to go or he's not going, it's just like, ah, come. So why are we all of a sudden going over his fact that he was shut in neat? Well, look, it's so nice out. It's a great time to have a talk. I honestly kind of assumed Subaru lived alone based on the first season when he got transported, because he was just he was buying like snacks and stuff, but I assumed it was like he lived in an apartment on his own kind of thing. Whatever brought him there really wants him to go to school. Silver hair. Is Amelia in this world with him? Or is this just his own thing? And he's just seeing Amelia. Wow, this is the first time he forgot. It's usually who's Rem, but now it's who's Amelia, and it's for him. He's got tears welling up in his eyes. Oh no, Subaru. He remembers! Okay. Sure. But like, sure. So he basically, like, he reached his peak of not trying. Well, not trying, but he reached his peak of natural athleticism in school and stuff. And so when everyone else was like, I'm going to try and do better, he just was going off of what he was doing and didn't quite keep up. So he was living in his own dad's shadow then? Like the whole time. So he just tried to be different. So he did his trademark hand pointing into the air and hip thrusting thing. Stop. Stop. you get back into that world and you save Rem now. You son of a bitch. That's not a headbutt. Even Subaru called him out. That's fucking axe kick. That's not a headbutt. What the fuck? Go with her. By going to school. Man, he can't do that. Because I'm sure he's going to... I think he's your only son. He can't do that because he's going to fucking go back to his world. Wait, I say his world, but his new world. You don't even know you're going back. You don't know this world is fake. I mean, he might, but... Stop. Oh, this is the first time I've seen an anime where they bring us back and make us realize that you can't go back again. Oh... There it is. Okay. You're gonna be pretty late. And then she goes the next day. Goodbye, room. Is she just straight eating mayonnaise? Why? I mean, who wouldn't choose the world over mayonnaise? I mean, how heartfelt conversations is he going to have with parents? Why is she walking him? Is it the same convenience store that he went to when he disappeared? It's like that's a weird place to take this. I mean, of course you're his mother. This is an interesting episode, and I feel like it kind of came out of nowhere. That's what he already realized. He's realizing it again. Oh. Oh. It's nice to see an isekai protagonist be able to say goodbye to their family. No. Oh. Stop. Just like poking him. No, I'm gonna cry. Oh, we're getting like right before he actually left. Oh. No. Oh, this is a long episode. It's only almost half an hour long. It's like, how long is this going? No one's there. Well, she's there. He's late. Motherfucker. Well, I kind of figured it was her, but still, like, come on. Well, fuck. If you guys enjoyed this reaction, please like, comment, and subscribe. Super helps out the channel. Link in the description to my Patreon and one to my Twitch. Also, click that notification bell so you know when the next episode is live. Other than that, thank you for coming to the party.